What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Today, I wanted to do like a get to know me type thing, but like in a fun way. Like, I'll tell y'all my personal traumas, my childhood traumas at a later time. I thought today would be something fun, like a favorite movies. Like, I love movies. All kind, drama, horror, romance. I like them all. A few that I have like favorites of, right? Like a few that I watch no matter how many times they come on, watch over and over again. Some of them I've seen several times. Some of them make me laugh at the same parts, cry at the same parts. Some of them I know all the words to. Today I just wanted to go through just a list of all my favorite movies. Before we begin, I do just want to let you guys know that if you could subscribe, also leave a comment. So since I'm talking about my favorite movies, let me know if y'all like any of these movies, if you have some similar ones. What's your favorite movies? I don't know if I'm in the center. It looks like I'm in the center. That's the center, I think. This is in no particular order. So what I did was like my favorite top 10 of all time, and then I did threw a couple of more in there, like some honorable mentions. First one I want to start with is Set It Off. Uh-oh, y'all can't see it. Set It Off. There you go. Boom, 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 boom. Because, yes, I still have a DVD player, and I have digital movies as well. Some of my favorite movies that I just cannot part with, so I'm going to keep my DVD. I was really, really young. Let's see. This came out in sometime in the 90s. It was a long fucking time ago. I had to fix the lighting. I felt like it was a little blown out. I really like Set It Off. It is about four girls who have just had terrible luck in life, and they had to do what they had to, what they thought they had to do to get ahead and to change the narrative and to change their life. So they took the drastic measures of robbing a bank, which a lot of people, and I feel like even true to this day, even with me, like I feel like financial struggles hold us back so much. Like they stop us from really living life. When you're burdened with how you're gonna eat and how you're gonna pay the bills, like that shit gets hard. I really understood their plight. Like, and even was okay with like robbing a bank. I know it's wrong, but the bank is insured, the money is insured, then people money will be fine. But I really love this. I love drive this car, Frankie. Drive this car.
Come on, Frankie, man, drive this car.
One of my top favorites. This is probably my number one or number two. My second one, which is the total contrast, right? It's a total contrast of Set It Off. The Lion King. No. Not the new one, right? I haven't seen it yet. I want to see it, but I kind of don't want to tarnish what I love, which is this. I love the story of the Lion King. Simba, I get, just wanted to run away and start over and just forget about the past. A lot of times your family can make you want to do that, make you not want to remember them. And sometimes your family can make you not want to be around and make you want to go somewhere else and just live a totally different life without them. I understand. I can relate. The Lion King to me is one of my all-time favorites. I know every song. I know every line. My favorite song in the movie is Scar. I know that your powers of redemption.
I know that your powers of redemption.
A Nightmare on Elm Street. My mother and my father were not together, but I used to go over to my dad's house a lot when I was a child. My daddy has a very extensive movie collection. So what I would do a lot at his house was watch movies. One of the genres that I fell in love with was horror. I watched a lot of horror. Like, it doesn't scare me, it's almost comforting. Like, I put on Freddy Krueger, Nightmare on Elm Street, when I'm ready to go to bed. Like, you know, you can watch Family Guy and American Dad and Golden Girls, and you can watch that kind of stuff at night and it just puts you to sleep. You've seen all of them, you know all the words, and it could just put you to sleep. That's how horror movies are for me. But Nightmare on Elm Street Part 1 for me was really, really good. I liked it because I love a hero story. You're not about to determine how things are gonna go for me. With Nancy, she was like, you know what, you is nothing. I take back my power. I take back. I love when she told him that towards the end of the movie. And she took all that shit back from him and was like, you're nothing. And turned her back on him.
I want my mother and friend again.
You what?
I take back every bit of energy I gave you. You're nothing. You're shit.
That's how I feel like you gain your energy from people, like your haters, your negative comments, the people who doubt you. Like, take all of that back. That is their issue, not yours. Turn your back on them and tell them you ain't nothing. And low-key, I always thought Freddy Krueger was kind of cute, but I'm saying. Identity was with Ray Liotta was in Identity, John Cusack, Rebecca De Mornay. It had a few people in it, but Identity was about, I think it was 6 or 7 people all showed up at this hotel during the middle of a storm. This is one that you really have to watch to get it. All of these 6 people were identities in a person who had dissociative identity disorder. And the movie was based on all of his, of him being integrated, of all of his identities coming together so he can become one person. However, one of his identities was a serial killer. So good. Acting really good. Story really good. Like, the plot of that, when that came out, like, was like, I'm not gonna give it away, but it's called Identity. I'll put it right there so you can take a look at the box and everything. Identity, really, really good. That's in my top 5. Scream, the original, the very first one. This redefined horror movies for me. It made them make fun of the whole horror genre, but not in a goofy way. My favorite scene is Drew Barrymore. One of my favorite lines is she flashed her shit all over town like she was Sharon Stone or somebody. And let's face it, she was no Sharon Stone.
We did your mom a favor, Sid. That woman was a slut bag whore who flashed her shit all over town like she was Sharon Stone or something.
Yeah, it would put her out of her misery. Because let's face it, Sidney, your mother was no Sharon Stone.
That was my favorite line in the movie. But Scream, I like all of them. Part 1 through 3, I even have 4. But another favorite, Dumb and Dumber. We'll put them over there. Dumb and Dumber. This comedy just literally had me laughing front to back. Jim Carrey to me is one of the best comedic actors out there. Just funny. It was just stupid. I love stupid funny. Like, I like smart funny too, but just stupid funny, just good, just Dumb and Dumber. That's in my top 10. What's love got to do with it? Okay, so I really love music. We'll get into that. That'll probably be another get to know me with my favorite music and artists and all of all time. It's Tina Turner's story with her and Ike, her upcoming and how she became this icon that she is. You would think that this type of movie would be very hard to watch because they did have a lot of domestic violence, rape, and just a lot of tough subject matter. But the music on top of it kind of just balanced it out. Like, I remember buying the CD and getting into all of these old songs from years ago because of this movie. And it was just really good. And it's not a sad movie. Like, it makes me feel good at the end of it. With so much trauma happening in it, you would think that it would make you feel some type of way. But it actually, at the end, when she do the what's love, you must understand, know the touch. When she do that song, it's like, I got you. And it makes you feel good. It's a really, really good movie. Next on my list is After Earth. I felt like it was a really good story. The premise is Earth is done with. We had to move out of Earth because humans had destroyed it. And him and his son had a very strained relationship. And Will Smith was a celebrated captain. And his son wanted to get his attention. And it was aliens. And it was just a really, really good story. And it was like he had a disconnect from his dad, but they came together with this crash. They crashed on Earth with it. But there was an alien that they had captured. It was really, really good. And he had to find his power and his voice in here. My movies have a theme, huh? I think my movies have a theme with finding yourself and being strong with yourself. Coming into your own, which is kind of like my life. The scene in this one with Jaden Smith that really made me look at him differently as an actor, and it tears me up every time, is when he was yelling at him and he was telling him to come on home, just forget it. The mission is over. You can't fix the problem. Just come on back. We gone. And he was like, no, what did you do?
What was I supposed to do? What did you want me to do? She gave me an order. She said, no matter what, don't come out of that box. Was I supposed to just come out and die?
It was so good, and it's just... Yeah, and that's kind of the moment where he took back his power and he said, fuck it. You know, he jumped off the cliff and did what he had to do. The next one is going to be I Am Legend. I do love a good horror movie. I love a good thriller. I love a good zombie apocalypse kind of where everybody had contracted this disease and had turned into these like night walking vampire type creatures. And he had to find the cure. He was trying to find the cure. A great performance. I love a movie where the acting is really good. Like, if you give me with the acting, then I'm here for it. Cruel Intentions came out in the 90s. It stars a young Sarah Michelle Gellar and Reese Witherspoon and Ryan Phillippe. A good story of privilege, coming into yourself. Great acting. Sarah Michelle Gellar is really good. I loved her from Buffy and All My Children, and he was on One Life to Live. And Reese, this was one of her earlier movies. Look how young she looked. I don't know if you can see her. Look how young Reese look on there. Okay, so I Am Legend was like the kind of my top 10. So these are like honorable mentions, right? I love them. I can watch them anytime. Not in my top 10, but very, very good. This one kind of should be in my top 10. I know all the words. I wanted a dragon. I wanted to see the Rock Man. I wanted every piece of it as a kid. I loved it. I still love it. To this day, I have 2 or 3 copies of this. I've had to buy it a few times. This one's really good. My favorite line in the movie is like the last line. Basically about a kid that is ditching school, has been bullied, and he loves to read, and he stole this magical book from a bookstore, and he's reading, and he's a part of the book. And as reading it, he's starting to see that his story is their story. And in the end, one of the parts is he has to name the main character name. And she was like, say my name, Sebastian, say my name.
Why don't do what you dream, Bastion.
But I can't. I have to keep my feet on the ground.
Call my name.
Bastion. Please. Save us. All right. I'll do it. I'll save you. I will do what I dream.
That part was like, say her name. And he said it. And, ah. It was great. This to me is, well, now this is family friendly. Definitely watch it with your kids. I think all kids now can enjoy this one. The when you look at it now, you definitely see how far we've come with technology, but this is a good one. Long Kiss Goodnight. Yeah, can you see that? Yeah. Long Kiss Goodnight. So this one, Gina Davis, Samuel Jackson. Samuel Jackson just, to me, plays in really good movies. Like, you very rarely find a movie that's not good that he's been in. Action-packed. She has amnesia and don't know who she is. She finds out that she was an assassin. And once the people who she worked for found out that she's back, they start to come after her. Almost done here. Thank you for sticking around. If you have stuck around this far, tell me right now, out of all the favorites that we've watched, out of all the favorites I've talked about, which one of those would be your favorite? Comment down below with a yellow heart if you got to this point in the video. Little Shop of Horror. This had to come out in the 80s, I believe, but a lot of people is in this. You know who's in it? Gina and Pam from Martin. Tisha Campbell and Tashina Arnold. They are in the quartet. Like, I love a musical. I love movies with music in it. And this got some of the best songs in the world. Downtown, where the cabs don't stop.
Go downtown, where your life's a joke. You go downtown, where you buy a toe. Can you go home to Skid Row? Home to Skid Row.
Yes, you go
downtown,
where the cabs don't stop.
Downtown.
Well, I might watch this right now. Another good one about it's an alien movie about a human eating plant. A Little Shop of Horrors, you just can't go wrong with. Like, if you have not seen it, you have to watch it. You just gotta take a look at that. And my final one, my honorable mention, Bridesmaids. This movie is hilarious to me. I've seen it probably 50,000 times. Every time I come on, you know, E! Network show it every other day. I watch it every time it's on. I'll put it on to go to bed at night. But to me, all of these girls, Kristen Wiig, Megan McCarthy, I don't know the other girl's name, Maya Rudolph, all of these girls in this movie are just fucking hilarious. It's had some of the best jokes in it. And it's just that. It's just about a bridesmaid and another person trying to figure out their life and on hard times. And that seems to be my theme. Now, y'all want to know something about me? I'm clearly all of these characters trying to figure my shit out and face my fears. And I'm also very funny, I think. So that was my favorite movies of all time with some honorable mentions. I wanted to do this because I feel like I got a few new followers on here, and I just want people to get to know me and hopefully stick around and tell your friends. And also, I want to know y'all. So tell me, what's y'all favorite movie? What out of my selection was your favorite movie? Out there, I'm always into watching something new. I watch movies literally 3-4 times a day. Try to find a bunch of new ones so I can add to my collection. But tell me what you guys think. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to Ron Daniel. I really appreciate it. And see you next time. Bye.